Look, the Lord has healed their eyes.
Ina no ruo to kayo wange. Tiwane suru suru sha. Moku ni sha de.
Jesus heals your people.
Yesu kayo adano pare.
Give the Lord a big hand of praise.
Waparu shingwa ire.
So remember, my friend.
Koiba jurimba.
God has anointed you.
Mungu daru ni wiri en gire.
Your tongue is anointed by God.
Lebi de kaitano shi mungu daru ni wiri lebi.
When you open your mouth and speak words of God,
teki yapu lebi ni wesho lembe pa mungu.
The Spirit of God touches you.
Tipu pa mungu binu bimuli.
And sets you free.
Man keti beda konya.
There is power in praising God.
Tegu tia ipaku mungu jofua.
And you people from Uganda are very special in praising God.
Wakembe wasunia wanu watano mi Uganda wakoti magui ipaku mungu.
The devil always wants us to focus on our problems.
Chitani wang mapol mitu kwa wabi wane npeku mua.
And that's why he keeps giving you worry after worry.
Eni ramuketi emenu pare. Peku kwa dienga shwinyi wia dienga shwinyi.
He keeps bringing problems after problems in your life.
Emenu peku kwa kupeku kwa iu ikuwa peri.
Because he wants you to focus on your problems.
Pirano sitani bemiti peri bang spe iberi nemperi peku peri.
But we who believe in Jesus.
Manu wanda wa iu yezu.
Instead of focusing on the problems.
Kaka ni menu peku.
We praise God.
Umakuwa pak yezu.
Hallelujah.
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 So remember, my friend.
Namukapo iba jurimba.
Whenever we praise God.
Kawabe paku mungu shi.
It paralyzes the enemies.
Enyotu tegupa jutmone.
It destroys the work of the enemy.
Mane nyotu tichpa jamone.
All his tactics are destroyed.
Kadirie kukumu kupangu pare sheke nyotu.
And God's blessing shows up in that place.
Emukisare mahuo kika peruma.
Hallelujah.
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 Amen.
And this battle that takes place, it does not take place outside. It takes place in your mind. And that's why we got to make a choice. That am I going to praise God? Or am I going to be depressed with my problems? And Jesus is saying to us, when we open our mouth and praise God,
we are
speaking our confidence that we trust God, that our God is bigger than our problem, that God is bigger than any situation that we face. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
There is always something or the other that will come to your mind to worry about. Now you will be saying, brother, you don't understand my problem. I know there is always going to be something or the other to worry about. But at the same time, there is so much more to something about to thank God for all that he has done for us and continues to do in our life.
Paribede watie kupeku ento tie niya mungu mwebit. Noki watie kukare mitaku mungu pipin maduang metimi kuomua.
Do we have a lot of things to thank God for?
Riandawa peku pingoma kuopaku ne mungu pire.
Look at around, there are people who do not have eyes. We have eyes, we have ears, we have hands, we have legs. We have the whole body healthy. We got to thank God for it.
Waki waneru darumoku wangimbe watie kuangwa. Darumoku chingimbe watie kushingwa. Darumoku chingimbe waru watie kuchendwa. Darumoku weshu ngo ento waru wabi weshu. Watie kulemba rimu maku wapakure mungu pire.
And when you become, when you have a spirit of thanksgiving.
Tanongi kentu kuope rupo mkutipu mipako mungu.
That becomes your lifestyle.
Egame noku ni kuoperi.
That determines your future.
Eya jikine, echare maketa njimperi nen.
Your future becomes awesome.
Edong anjimpe idoku nipinjimira zunga.
So every day in our life.
Edong kupani dikuomua.
The choice is us.
Wandre mawatie kulondone.
Will I praise God?
Nyavipa akumungu.
In the midst of pressure.
Inindu mipeko.
Or am I going to grumble and complain?
Ununja bimpe dukwani ngoro manape yuak ikumpeko para.
Or am I going to be full of worry and fear?
Nyopeko kuluoru bipongare.
Because whatever I choose to do determines my future. How many of you believe your future is in God's hand?
Yeah.
Those who are in the morning, they are not lifted their hands up.
Daro mu perugo kwenu gitimu shingi ngopirango gingeyo pirango.
Because they now know the truth.
Daro nwamu poli jomu petimu shingi kawoni gingeyo nganda.
I want to ask you a quick question.
Donabe penji wa penji moko mu pio pio.
Who messed up Adam's future?
Na maonyo to ajimpa Adamure.
God.
Mungu.
Satan.
Sitani.
Eve.
Eva.
Or Adam.
Ni Adamure.
He only went and spoke to Adam.
Eva ushituwesha wesha kende ibanga Adamu.
But Adam made a decision to disobey God.
Eto Adamure ma upedu kumiti mitoro shikpa Mungu.
So my friend, every day in our life, the choice that we make decides our future. If I make a decision, no matter what happens, whether I feel good or not, I'm going to praise God, I'm going to thank God, I'm going to trust God, even though I see all things going negative. When I start praising God, that praise will open the doors of heaven. And God will intervene in that situation and destroy that situation. And the victory will come. But the victory doesn't come.
Then
I make a choice to believe in God. Let me give an example. There was once
a king.
There was once a king. This king's name was King Joseph. In 2 Chronicles chapter
20.
He has got a small kingdom. And there are 3 kings who are his enemies. They come together and they make a plan. We will get our armies together and King Joseph will be no match for us, and we will kill him completely. We'll take over his kingdom. King Joseph doesn't know this plan.
Joseph atungeyungo peko lemba pora eni.
This huge army is marching by.
Edom ju asikari pa ju yuda giberu kawotu.
When they are just 2 days distance from King Joseph.
Ju eni gisa madongi dong nindumoku wario kende ni tuchi bangro of Joseph.
The news reaches King Joseph.
Gin kwenda gamu tuchi bang Joseph.
That a great army is coming to kill him.
Ya udul patano pepiru rimeki.
He is filled with fear.
Epo mkuluoru.
My friend.
Jarimba.
When we hear bad news, when we use painful news, when we listen to news of destruction, of a bad future, instantly there will be fear. In the same way, King Joseph is filled with fear. He knows he's going to be killed. But he is a man of God. He turns his face to God. He tells the whole country, let us go to fast. And let us pray to God. And King Joseph starts his prayer. The first thing he says, oh God, you are so almighty. There is no God like you
Mungu,
you are so mighty and powerful that no one can withstand you. God, you are the God who helped our ancestors. Our ancestors were able to pass through the Red Sea. You are the same God. You are the same God that brought us out of Egypt. He is praising God for who he is. He's thanking God for all that he had done in the past. And now he reminds God, God, we have a covenant with you. God, we have a covenant with you. You said, God, when we are in trouble, when there's a storm, when there's pestilence, when there's any problem, when we come to your temple and turn to you and ask you to help us,
kuiwa.
That you will surely help us.
Ni andanda ibikonywa.
He reminds God of his promise. And he cries out to God. And he says three things. Oh God, without you, we are powerless. Oh God, without you, we are powerless. Oh God, without you, we are powerless. The army that is coming against us. We don't know what to do. We don't know what to do. We don't know what to do.
But
one thing we know. Oh Lord.
Ruth.
Our eyes are fixed on you. Our eyes are fixed on you. Our eyes are fixed on you. He is not saying our eyes are fixed on the enemy. He is not saying our eyes are fixed on that enemy that is so big. He is not saying the enemy is so large that he will kill us. But he's saying our eyes are fixed on you. When he makes that prayer, the Spirit of God comes. And the prophecy comes.
Okay. Lembe mira tucha nen.
And God says to King Joseph.
Mungu gamuwa shuni jihot Josephat.
Listen, King Joseph.
Winji baru wa Josephat.
You shall not fight this battle.
Hili bikenu monyenu ngo.
You shall not fight this battle.
Ibikenu monyenu taku ngo.
This battle belongs to the Lord.
Ya, monyenu tiepo mungu en.
God will fight the battle for you.
Mungu bikenu monyenu hili.
And this evening I've come to tell you, my friend. You and I are not supposed to fight the battle. The battle belongs to the Lord. And the Lord will fight the battle for you. The Lord will fight the battle for you. But here is what he says to King Joseph.
Enter winland bebe washo mebe ni Ruth Josephat.
Josephat.
Josephat washo.
Take your position.
Ni adong nuanka bedu peri mi libu.
Three things.
Pinya beg.
Take your position.
Pinya rachel. Nuanka bedu peri mi shungi yetir.
Stand still.
Chungdi.
And see.
Money man.
And see.
Money man. Chungi money timano.
And see.
Amen.
How the Lord will deliver you. Three things. Take your position. Stand still. And see the deliverance. The Lord will bring for you. First one. Take your position. What is the position that we take in our life? There were two sisters in the Bible. One's name was Mary. And the other one was Martha. Jesus went to their house. And Jesus began to teach. Mary sat at Jesus' feet. Martha went inside to cook food. And she began to tell Jesus. Jesus, look at Martha, Mary. She's not coming to help me. And Jesus said, Mary has taken the right position. Mary knew. What Jesus is teaching me is very important. It will help me in my life. It will help me to develop my relationship with Jesus. I don't want to go anywhere. I want to be with my Jesus. I want to be with my Jesus. She took a position. My friend, in the midst of your problems, what position are you taking? Are you taking a position of crying?
Are you taking a position of fear? Are you taking a position of accusing everybody? Are you taking a position of complaining and grumbling? Are you taking a position of anger and bitterness? Are you taking a position of focusing on your family? Jesus is saying, take a position with him. That same Jesus is saying to you this evening. Take your position with him. First one. How do I take this position? I take this position through the word of God. That's why the Spirit of God said to King Joseph. Stand still. Because our mind cannot stand still. Our mind keeps wavering. One moment we'll be dancing. One moment we'll be praising God. When we leave this place and the problem comes, that's the time we need to praise God. But that's the time you are angry. That's the time you are offended. That's the time you are bitter. That's the time you want to speak all the negative words. So are you standing still? Are you all the time double-minded? Are you all the time wavering? God is saying to you, stand still. Get this mind on the promise of God. No matter what happens, I'm going to speak what God said. And the third thing he says, King Joseph,
Ruth Josephat,
see, how the Lord will deliver you.
Itema Ruth bigonyi kude.
The news that he heard,
kwenda mewinju,
2 days back,
inge inindario.
That news was saying,
kwenda esha bewasho,
King Joseph, you are going to be killed.
Nia, Ruth Josephat, inge inijubeshineki.
You got no chance to survive. The army coming against you is too big for you. You cannot be saved. You
will
surely die.
And then this is all.
Your army will be wiped out.
There is
no chance for you. That's on one side. On the other side, the Holy Spirit is saying, King Joseph, your army don't need to go and fight. Because God himself will fight for you. In the same way, in our lives too, God wants to fight your battle. God wants to intervene in your life. God wants to do mighty things in your life. My friend, what do you see? What do you see? Do you see what Jesus said? Or do you see what your problem is saying? What your pain is saying? What your sorrow is saying? What your poverty is saying? What the occult is saying? What witchcraft is saying? What are the things that you see? Because whatever you see, that's what is going to manifest. And God is saying to Joseph, I don't want you to see the negative things that are going to happen. Even though the things are negative against you, you believe in me. And you see, before it can happen, that I will deliver you. King Joseph believes the truth. The next day he gets the army. And he tells them, believe in the Lord. And believe in the prophecy. He takes the music, the choir before the army. How many over here? In the choir.
would
like to go with King Jehoshaphat's army.
Wanadi kimbwa wajuruwere mawabemitu washiti wang asikari paru Jehoshaphat.
King Jehoshaphat did not put the choir after the army. He put them before the army.
Ruo Jehoshaphat uketungo juruweri inge asikari enteketu juruweri wang asikari.
So who gets the first arrow?
Na maonu wangatero mirasielere.
The army or the choir?
Asikari kunu nyo asikari kunu yo juruweri. Piyonki mbeku pinmoku. The choir.
So how many of you would like to join the choir where you get the first shot?
Nungunge unga ikindu wa juruweri. Makipe mitu kipe juruweri. Makuni sipe nungati mirasiel. Malakatero kembeki in.
Nobody's talking now.
Hey, where should I come from?
Nobody's talking. But King Jehoshaphat's choir are all excited.
Eto, asikar, I mean, juruwer paru Jehoshaphat chekebedu kudanyonga.
They go before the army.
Gishiti wang asikari.
Please don't get distracted.
Puni wake wawesha kesha ya wia.
I'm coming to the best part.
Ebe birudong idiere milembene.
Hello, please don't get distracted.
Nongkulembe moku jeb ngechimua.
Please don't talk.
Kudi weshipa.
Because that's exactly what's going to happen here now.
Any relembe moshiti mireka uoni eni gakeni.
Please don't talk.
Puni kewechi awia.
Now listen to this.
Winjilembe.
The choir goes before the army.
Long juruweru shiti wana sikari.
Why are the choir going before the army?
Pirango ama juruweru be shiti wana sikari.
They have no fear of death.
Gipe kuluoru pato.
They have no fear of death.
Gipe kuluoru pato.
They are going before the army.
Gipe shiti wana sikari.
The enemy will wipe them out.
Mana sikari miki jumone miki peshi nyoto gisheke.
Then why are they going before the army?
Pirango ama gipe shiti wana sikari.
Because they believe God's word.
Pirango giyu lebe pa mungu.
And what God had told them.
Man lebe ma mungu nyuti.
God had told them.
Mungu nyutu igi.
The battle belongs to me.
Nia luinye nutie pare.
The battle belongs to me.
Luinye nutie pa mungu.
Even this evening.
Kani kuretu eni.
You might have any problem in your body.
Nyitie kupeku moki kuope.
You might have any sickness or disease in your body. Nyitie
kutuo moki kumi.
That same God is saying.
Ruotumarome nubewashu.
This battle is mine.
Nia monye nutie para mungu.
I'm willing to fight the battle.
Anatia hika mingedu monye.
But you like King Joseph at the army.
Indom shalo ruot Josephat.
Are willing to praise God?
Utia hika mipako mungu.
Are you willing to trust God?
Itia hika migenu mungu. Watia hika?
The choir went before the army.
Edona sikari enu gijuru erubeni wangi.
And they said these words.
Mangi washo lembe ma e.
Please remember these words.
Don winji lembe ma e amaper.
Please remember these words.
Po hikum lembe ma e giba.
I've seen in my life.
Eneni kuopare.
Saying the same words.
E washo lembe ma romeni.
I've got tremendous victories in my life.
E tie kupeku matongtongi kuopare.
When you say these words,
kai winju lembe maeni, kai yero lembe mae,
you put the powers of darkness into confusion.
Iketu lembe mimudu ya nyoba nyoba tekiwesho lembe maeni.
Let me say that again.
Mediri ni washo lembe ni.
When you say these words of God,
kai wesho lembe pa mungu eni,
demons get confused.
Sitani wiginjebiri.
And they fight among themselves.
Mantipu marichu chaka gudiri kingi.
And they destroy themselves.
Kishakuchi amiri kingi.
Do you want to destroy the demonic forces?
Nongibe miti nyote kumitipu marichu na emi kuoperi?
Oh, it was very soft, yes.
Kore washu wawagamo shenya gum gum.
You like the demonic forces?
Omaro sitani.
You like the demonic forces?
Omaro tipu marichu beru nyonu. They have refused it.
Then shall we put them into confusion?
The
demons will fight among themselves.
And that's
what happened.
On one side
the choir was singing.
Praises
of God.
Juruweru beruka pako mungu.
The enemies were far away.
Jumone kiberuka mabori.
They could not even hear them singing.
Gira mungoni winju kiberuweru ne.
Very far away.
Kiberuka mabori.
But the moment they began to sing.
Eto kidema kishaku ni weru.
The Bible says.
Biblia bewashu.
The Lord put confusion in the enemy's field.
Mungu gamudro ya nyoba nyoba ikinjumone.
The whole army, the three kings and the whole army began to fight against each other.
Duka sikari ikinruta bikya. Ukweru nirambu gishaku kibiri kedi kingigigi.
And they killed each other.
Gishaku negiri kingigigi.
The next day when King Joseph and the army reached the place,
Dong ininduma asikari pa Joseph, Josephat ku Ruth negituchika beruesha.
They saw thousands and thousands of people all dead.
Kinanu dul danelifu kunelifu mupo ikingigigi.
And on their body were precious stones.
Mani korgi ubenu kinimapira tek orgi.
And there were jewelry. The Israelites, the King Joseph and his army went over there and took out all the jewels and all that.
And on Ruth Joseph had kuna sikari pare, gisakwa beshitu kashoku orgi, kuno silver gi, kumola matung tungi, gishoku.
They became extremely rich.
Gigam gilan lan pukwek.
Everything changed.
Pinche kelo kire kuamiki.
Because of their praise.
Pirama opak mikire mumiku ikimuki samilonyo.
So when you are going to say these words, I'm going to give you those words. No matter what wrong is happening in your life, it will be destroyed. And financial blessings will come on your life. Nobody's happy. No, you don't want any financial blessings. Your people in Uganda don't want financial blessings.
Don't. Uganda
they want.
Then when I was speaking, you are so cold. Because whatever you are responding, heaven is watching you. Devil is watching you. Angels are watching you. God is watching you. Holy Spirit is watching you. And when you respond with faith, your faith destroys the work of the devil.
Amen.
Let me give you the words. The words go this way. Praise the Lord.
Pak mungo.
For he is good. His mercy endures forever. Praise the Lord.
Pak mungo.
For he is good. His mercy endures forever.
Kisa man marvare ripinaka.
My friend.
Jale.
Jale.
Hey, Jaremo.
Jaremo.
Hey, yo.
Jaremo.
Jaremo.
Jaremo, can you make a song quickly?
Dongi kenu ang wer mokuma ber maleng mipako un pamongo.
Praise the Lord for your good, your mercy endures forever.
Pak ruot piramo kisa pare barbare de ripinaka.
And then we will sing that.
Don't worry.